there, welcome to my channel. I am so glad you clicked on this video because today I am going to reveal a hidden gem in CLO 3D that you might have overlooked. But before we get into that, make sure you hit that subscribe button and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss any of my future videos. And if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Alright, are you ready for this? Let's go! You might remember this tool from Notch Tool class. But back then, we didn't go into much detail about seam allowance. That's why today we will dive deeper into this topic and learn how to use it like a pro. First of all, we need to understand what seam allowance is and why it matters. Seam allowance are the area between the edge of the fabric and the stitching line. Seam allowance enables you to stitch the garment piece together and to attach other garment parts such as closure, trimmings, facings, and collars. The allowance may vary from 0.5 to 3.5 cm. Depending on the material structure, fabric weight, the intended seam finishes, and garment design. For example, most garment seams have 1 cm seam allowance, while shaped seams such as necklines have 0.5 cm seam allowance. Seam allowance is important for the proper fit and appearance of the garment. So, where can you find this magical tool in CLO 3D? It's right here in the 2D panel between its tool. It's next to our trace tool. You can notice a blue line when you hover over your pattern. That's the seam allowance indicator. To apply it, you can select the area where you need it and it will turn yellow along with a new black line a little away from your main pattern. This is your actual seam allowance line. You can check out its property from the property editor, and when you right click over it, only one option will become available, and that is delete. So you can take the action from here, or you can use delete key from the keyboard. But if you want to remove all your seam allowance at once, then you can do Ctrl plus A to select all and follow the same steps that we have learned just now. Now, it's time to see its property. It's the only place where you can edit it apart from deleting it. Here, we have width first. So, you can decide the distance between your fabric edge and stitch line. Write the value as you like, but keep in mind that it's in inches, so type it accordingly. I'm keeping it at 1 for now. Next we have seam type. We basically have 3 options here: star, end, and intersection. But for now only 2 options are active. So let's check out what they are. Under star we have 3 types. So let me select them one by one. What does this thing do? It is not doing anything. It might be possible that the other side of our line is actually the starting point for this. So, let's check that out. Yes, our guess is correct. It changes the shape of the seam allowance on this side of the line and has the same option, which means same result on the other side. Now, let's check why intersection is not working. Well, my friend, think carefully. We need 2 lines to meet to create an intersection, but currently we have only 1. So let's add 1 more line to any adjacent side of this. Now we can change its width and all. And here we got an intersection instead of a star. By sacrificing 1, we got another. So we have a variety of shapes in intersection, and their use depends on the shape and need of your design. Just keep one thing in mind, seam allowance is also similar to notch tool, which means it can only be selected by using its tool. If you want to apply similar seam allowance all over your pattern, then you can drag your mouse like this to select all the pattern pieces. While creating garments at an industrial level, it's important to export the pattern with the seam allowance. That's why now we will learn how to do that. We have various file formats to export pattern, but for now, I will export it as PDF. Now that you have selected the option, you need to give it a name and location. Then you will get some options to customize your PDF, and here is the one we need, seam allowance. Check this box and your seam allowance will be added to your exported pattern. To show you the difference, I will export another pattern without it. Here are our PDF and this is what sets them apart. The extra line in this pattern is for our seam allowance. Pretty cool, right? I hope you enjoyed this video. If you are as passionate about fashion as I am, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and stay tuned for more unique and exciting classes coming your way. I can't wait to share my experience with you and inspire you to express yourself through fashion. See you in the next video. Bye. Happy designing.